Hello and welcome. You're watching NDTV. I'm Vedant Agarwal. Our lead story, well, a fresh spell of violence in Manipur, a state limping back to normalcy. In fact, in the past 24 hours, at least 12 people have died, the latest being the 6 deaths in the Jiribam district. The chief minister met the governor of Manipur over the security situation. This as questions are being raised as to why violence is returning to Manipur, given the fact that there is extensive security cover in the state. Ratandeep Chaudhary reports. More deaths in Manipur as violence continues in a major escalation since Friday. On Saturday morning, armed groups of both communities allegedly attacked each other. There was severe gunfight in the Jiribam district bordering Assam. 6 people died, with both sides suffering deaths. The firing followed the rocket attack on Friday at Bishnupur district's Moirang. The rocket landed on the residence of Manipur's first Chief Minister Koiring Singh, next to the INA Museum, killing 1 and injuring 6.
So we feel that over the past 15 months, we all know that more than 60,000 Central Armed Forces are being deployed. There are around 35,000 of state police personnel. And despite all this heavy deployment of armed forces, there isn't any sign of restraint. Now, the people have already started feeling that our civilian populations are not safe anymore.
Security forces have launched a major offensive in the fringe areas between the hills and the valley region. In the Imphal Valley, civil society groups have asked for a public emergency to be declared, saying they don't feel safe despite the huge presence of central forces. In the capital, Imphal, shops and schools remained shut and public transport was off the roads. Kuki groups deny allegations of sparking this fresh escalation.
So it's very unfortunate, and we do not want any casualty from both sides. But if we are being attacked, we have no choice but to defend ourselves. We also get to know that the Chief Minister of Manipur, N. Biren Singh, is about to be removed. And it is his last ploy, his last tactic that he wanted to play some drama in Manipur.
The incidents are almost a rerun of last year's violence. On Friday night in Imphal, there was also an attempt by hundreds of people to loot the armory.
Yesterday, late in the evening, in Imphal, there was an attempt to loot arms at 7 MR Khabai Soi and at 2nd MR Imphal. The combined security forces deployed at these locations with some resistance were able to successfully disperse the mob and repel that attempt. Later on, while the reinforcement party from our police who were returning, they were fired upon by some miscreants at Khabai Soi, in which our officer inspector KH Henry, OC Commando Imphal East, and one constable Isaac Gangmai, they got injured.
Manipur once again is back on the tenterhooks. With BM Sunzu in Imphal and K Mangte in Churachandpur, Ratandeep Chaudhary's report for NDTV. The latest now from poll-bound Haryana. Well, the face-off over wrestlers now in the Congress's den. Well, assault-accused MP Brijbhushan Sharan Singh has hit out at the wrestlers, saying that this proves that the wrestlers' movement was nothing but a Congress conspiracy. Meanwhile, wrestler Bajrang Punia has hit back. He says, "Our protests were never political. We never allowed a political leader to, in a sense, come up on the stage when we were protesting in Delhi's Jantar Mantar." But the Congress also now upping the ante against the BJP. Take a look.
18 जनवरी को जब जंतर मंतर पर 2023 में धरना प्रारंभ हुआ था, तो मैंने पहले दिन कहा था कि ये खिलाड़ियों का आंदोलन नहीं है, इसके पीछे कांग्रेस है, विशेष करके भूपेंद्र हुड्डा, दीपेंद्र हुड्डा, प्रियंका जी, राहुल जी, ये कांग्रेस का आंदोलन है। और आज ये बात सच साबित हुई।
उस समय आप उस समय वो देख लीजिए कि भाई किस किन लोगों ने हमें आंदोलन पे बिठाया था और कौन लोग थे, कांग्रेस के थे या और किसी के थे। और उस समय ना हमारा राजनीति से कोई लेना देना था, स्टार्टिंग के हमने किसी राजनेता को मंच पे नहीं चढ़ने दिया था और बीजेपी के नेताओं को हमने लेटर लिख के दिया है, अगर वो फिर भी नहीं आए तो उनका काम है ये नैरेटिव फैलाना कि भाई ये कांग्रेस पार्टी ने करवाया था, ये फलाने ने करवाया था। ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, पूरे देश ने देखा और आज भी पूरा देश खिलाड़ियों की बेटियों के साथ खड़ा है।
चार्जशीट में उनका नाम है, विनेश फोगाट को वो अटैक कर रहे हैं, बाकी छह लड़कियों ने पर भी तो आपके ऊपर यौन शोषण का आरोप लगाया है, क्या वो आरोप चला गया है? किसको नहीं याद है कि आपके खिलाफ तो कोई कार्रवाई नहीं कर रही थी मोदी सरकार, वो तो भला हो सुप्रीम कोर्ट का, दिल्ली पुलिस आपको बचाते हुए घूमती रही। और विनेश फोगाट ने बड़ी हिम्मत से, बड़ी शिद्दत से एक लड़ाई लड़ी थी, अपने हक की लड़ाई लड़ी थी, और उसके बाद उस लड़की को जिस तरह से जमीन पर घसीटा गया, बूटों तले रौंदा गया, और उसके बाद वो ओलंपिक जाती है और ऑलमोस्ट स्वर्ण पदक जीत कर, जिसकी वो हकदार थी, वो जीत जाती।
Well, this, as the internal dissent and rebellion continues in the BJP, a string of resignations and high-profile ones at that, the latest being ex-Haryana Minister Bachchan Singh, who has dumped the party, has resigned from all party positions. This is loyalists continue to say that the old guard was ignored and turncoats were rewarded. Listen in to what Chief Minister Nayab Singh Saini had to say.
बिल्कुल मना रहे हैं उनको,
सीएम साहब बराड़ा साहब
उनमें गुस्सा है, बिल्कुल मना रहे हैं, बराड़ा जी काम करेंगे और इसी क्षेत्र के अंदर लोगों के लिए वो वोट भी मांगने की अपील करेंगे। और भारतीय जनता पार्टी है, भारतीय जनता पार्टी एक मुस्त होकर के तीसरी बार सरकार बना रहे हैं।
Meanwhile, our special report, well, women leaders within the BJP say that they've been sidelined given the fact that there is only a very little chunk of women who've been given tickets this time around. They say, where is the 33% reservation promise? Take a look.
Women BJP leaders in Haryana unhappy with poor representation in the first list. Despite the celebration over the BJP's 33% women's reservation bill, they have given tickets to 8 women in the first list of 67 candidates. That is only about 12%.
अबकी बार विधानसभा के चुनाव में ये मैं खुद नहीं समझ पा रही, क्योंकि मेरे पास सभी महिलाओं के फोन आ रहे हैं, महिला पदाधिकारियों के आ रहे हैं कि मैडम ये बात समझ में नहीं आई कि अब की बार महिला पदाधिकारियों को 33% जो टिकट मिलनी चाहिए थी वो क्यों नहीं मिल पाई। तो इसका कारण मैं भी समझ नहीं पा रही कि कहाँ नेतृत्व में ने, मतलब कहाँ पे क्या कमी रह गई कि जो महिलाओं को टिकट मिलनी चाहिए थी विधानसभा में और उसमें क्यों नहीं मिल पाई।
बीजेपी टिकट एस्पिरेंट फ्रॉम पंचकुला रंजीता मेहता इज आल्सो अनहैप्पी।
तो हम पार्टी से उम्मीद करते हैं कि कहीं ना कहीं महिला रिप्रेजेंटेशन बढ़ानी चाहिए।
The Congress too has given a ticket only to 5 women in its first list of 32. When that may be 16% slightly better than the BJP, neither party is anywhere near the 33% promised in the bill. With Gurpreet Singh Chinna, NDTV Bureau Report.
Meanwhile, the Congress AAP Alliance in Haryana also hitting seat-sharing hurdles. The Aam Aadmi Party is saying that it's not going to settle for anything less than 10 seats. The Congress, particularly the Hooda camp, is unwilling to concede as well. But there was a huddle and there's hope for some seat-sharing agreement. Take a look.
उम्मीद है कि फाइनलाइज होगा, उम्मीद है, उम्मीद पर दुनिया कायम है, उम्मीद पर दुनिया कायम है।
सर मुझसे ही ये कहा था कि हम बहुत सिंगल डिजिट में और बहुत कम नंबर आम आदमी पार्टी,
अभी भी वही परिस्थिति है।
क्या वो तैयार है इस बात से, क्योंकि उनकी भी रजामंदी बहुत जरूरी है।
वो जो है मैं समझ रहा हूँ कि वो भी तैयार हो जाएंगे। विन विन सिचुएशन किसको कहते हैं।
And with that, we'll slip into a short break now, but news continues on the other side. Welcome back. News now from Lucknow. Well, a building collapsed in the Transport Nagar area of the city, a popular commercial area in Lucknow. And at least five people, in fact, have died in this building collapse. Many others have been injured severely. 20 people have been injured. The rescue operations continue. Take a look. News now from Tamil Nadu, where a controversial motivational speaker, or a spiritual orator as it were, has been arrested by the police. This after there was a massive controversy over a government school giving platform to this motivational speaker. He had reportedly made some contentious remarks on the differently abled as well. Let me go across straight to my colleague Sam Daniel joining us on the phone line. So Sam, this is an important development. There was massive uproar over some of the remarks he had made. The headmistresses were transferred as well. And now the spiritual orator has been arrested. Break it down for us. Who exactly is this man?
Well, Vedant, his name is Mahavishnu. He is a spiritual orator and he had delivered address to students at two government schools on invitation by the government school principal. And in one of those schools, he had allegedly spoken what many call as superstitious speech, saying that the misdeeds of one in their earlier birth would lead to deformity and disability. And this was immediately objected to by a differently abled teacher in that school, saying that you were asked to give a motivational speech, but not a superstitious speech. And it became a talking point across the state. And immediately the school education department transferred the two principals who were invited in, ordered a probe. And now on his return from Australia, he was first detained and now he has been remanded to judicial custody. Police have invoked the Rights of People with Disabilities Act, besides other sections. And they say he had, misbehaved with the different table teacher in that school when he objected to. And this kind of superstitious talk is not allowed in a school where scientific temper ought to be nurtured. But those who support him, they deny his allegations, saying that his intention was never to hurt the sentiments of the differently abled people, and that his past talks would vouch for his good intentions. And now the school education department has also ordered a probe to understand exactly who invited him and how was it allowed to permit this kind of superstitious talk on campus. And the government has now given new guidelines in terms of the modalities to be followed to invite people, especially when it comes to motivational talks and things like that.
Sure.
And the aim, they say, should be only to nurture a scientific temper, but not to mislead children in terms of such superstitious talks as it happened this week. Let's wait and see how the court would view it. But at the moment, this man has been arrested.
Hmm.
His supporters deny his allegations.
All right, Sam, thanks very much for joining us with the latest there. And this entire spiritual speaker business has really become a menace and a nuisance across the country. Moving now, well, the government has suspended or sacked Pooja Kherkar, the controversial IAS trainee from the services. This comes just perhaps months after the UPSC also decided to cancel her selection. The government in its note says that Pooja Kherkar has been found guilty of cheating. Remember, she had come under the scanner after there were allegations of her, you know, getting out of turn benefits and also seeking privileges that she was not entitled to. Her mother had also come under the scanner in a separate case, but she has now been discharged from services. And now a hero's welcome for our Paralympic stars. Well, India's bagged 27 medals at the Paralympics. Truly a historic feat there by our star athletes. In fact, Sports Minister Mansukh Mandavia also met our Paralympic stars. In fact, the Prime Minister also dialed some of the gold medalists there. Some of the medalists were spoken to by the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister also congratulating them and talking to them about the struggles of their training and how they really were able to overcome those struggles. So, a hero's welcome there for our Paralympic stars. And well, colour and euphoria, excitement on the streets of Mumbai and indeed across Maharashtra and the country, well, as India celebrates Ganesh Chaturthi. And look at how elephants were also, you know, in a sense, they participated in the Ganesh Chaturthi celebrations across the country. In fact, this is a long-standing tradition in India, how elephants are also, in a sense, offered prayers too during the Ganesh Chaturthi festival. And this is in fact a visual from the Nilgiris where Madhumalai elephants participated in the Ganesh Chaturthi celebrations. And now our special exclusive with star writer duo Saleem Javed. Well, they told NDTV in their rare appearance on television about the struggles of being screenwriters in the 80s and also how the split impacted them. Well, they also have news for all of us. They say that they are working on a script together.
Javed sahab aur aapki jodi, jo iconic jodi mani jati hai, uska khayal kisko aaya tha?
उसका ख्याल ये आया कि हम साथ में काम कर रहे थे और यहाँ सिप्पी फिल्म के अंदर एक स्टोरी डिपार्टमेंट बनाया था उन्होंने अपना रमेश सिप्पी ने, तो उसमें एक कमरा था, एक फ्लैट था, उसमें एक कमरा था, वहाँ हम लोग बैठ के काम करते थे। तो सब अपने अपने आइडियाज़ लाते थे, सब अपने अपने वो लेके आते थे प्लॉट और उस पर काम करते थे। तो उसमें हम, मैं और जावेद साहब ने कहा कि वहाँ चलते हैं, नौकरी ढूंढते हैं, इसलिए काम हम तो था नहीं। तो वी वेंट देयर, तो उन्होंने कहा कि कुछ सुनाइए आपके पास कुछ हो। तो हमने अपने पास जो प्लॉट थे या जो भी क्या कैरेक्टर थे उस सुनाए, तो उन्होंने हमको 750 रुपये महीने पर रख लिया, समझे। और उसके बाद जो हमारी तरक्की होती जाएगी 7.5 से 10,000।
लेकिन स्टोरी के आइडियाज आपके ही आते थे
जी?
स्टोरी आइडियाज आपके,
स्टोरी आइडियाज होते थे, सब फिर जो होते थे उनके जो राइटर थे वो बैठ के उसका कमरे में काम करके उसकी इसकी बनाते थे स्क्रिप्ट। उस जमाने में वो पिक्चर वाली अंदाज, हाँ, जिसमें राजेश खन्ना था, जिंदगी एक सफर है सुहाना,
ब्लॉकबस्टर
सुपर सुपरहिट गाना था वो था। और उस जमाने में बनी है सीता और की किताब बनी है, उस जमाने में ये ऑफिस में जो बनी थी स्क्रिप्ट उनमें से ही है।
सलीम साहब, ये बताइए मुझे, आपने कहा कि ये दिमाग में नहीं था कि पैसे ज़्यादा लेने हैं, लेकिन राइटर की स्थिति को सुधारने का उसको
वो तो बहुत ही ऐसा लगता था कि बहुत ही जाती है वो, बहुत
यू हैड इट इन योर माइंड दैट हैज टू बी चेंज्ड।
ये क्या अचार, और इसकी वजह से ऐसा लगता है कि इसकी कोई यानी कोई वैल्यू नहीं है, यानी इसकी सिर्फ। तो वो था कि यार अच्छा। और दूसरी बात ये कि वो जो किया था, वो जिसने हंगामा मचा दिया था, वो नाम नहीं था हमारा,
आपने स्टैम्प किया।
जब पिक्चर रिलीज हो रही थी जंजीर, तो उसमें नाम नहीं था। अब जंजीर तो ऐसी फिल्म की थी जिसकी पूरी कंप्लीट स्क्रिप्ट थी हमारे पास, जो हमने पूरी स्क्रिप्ट बेची है, समझे, और उसमें हमारा नाम नहीं। तो हमने कही कि क्या बात हुई, नाम नहीं है। तो हमने एक पेंटर को लिया और उसके साथ पेंट को दिया, उसको एक गाड़ी दी, उसको एक लेटर दिया और कहा कि पूरे जितने बॉम्बे के अंदर वो हैं आपके
पोस्टर
सबके ऊपर वो फिल्म के अंदर रिटर्न बाय सलीम जावेद। तो अब वो रात को गया, जब दरबार पे पी ली होगी उसने, वो चढ़ के उसने लगाना शुरू की थी, कभी किसी के मुँह पे लग गया तो किसी के हाथ पे लग गया, तो वो सब के सब, तो वो झटका बहुत बड़ा लगा सबको। तो